powerful frequency to leave the human body is? The frequency of authenticity. So as I went down this spiritual rabbit hole, I said, well, where does this frequency come from? It comes from the brain. In my entire speaking career brings me greater pain than to share this with you ladies. But because I'm about to alienate all of my male counterparts. But frequency comes from an area of the brain called the gray matter. And it's official, and it just turns me to the core to admit this. Women have more brain cells than men. Women have more brain cells than men. This is a fact. Oh, I know a lot of you guys are calling your spouse at the break. I told you so. In fact, when I found this clinical study, my fiance was in the shower. True story. I ran into the bathroom and I said, oh God, babe, you're not going to believe what I just uncovered. She goes, duh.
Brought this up right here. The shift that is happening is called the divine timeline. So basically, let me put it to you like this. So you playing a multiplayer game as a single player. So what I mean is, like, in a previous reality, you would switch to your other selves, right? So now we're in what's called the divine timeline or the golden timeline, where other versions of yourselves compress together to create your true self, which is who you'll become for New Earth or the Golden Age, whatever you want to call it. So basically, imagine you were a piece of pie. You split your pie off into 8 pieces and gave it off to 8 different dimensions. And you told them not to eat the pie, but you can enjoy the smell, do all that. That's your experience. And then when the time comes for the party, they say, I need everybody to bring that slice of pie back. And that's you. You getting your slices of pie back to create the full pie, which is you. So yeah, some of these memories you having is just your other selves' memories compressing in your second strand of DNA or DEA, whatever you want to call it. That information is compressing as energetic data to save. So I'm telling you, bro, we about to hit that new wave, baby. Follow, like, subscribe, baby, and share. Leave a comment.
Hologram, they're thinking of a Walt Disney little pixie dancing around in a little darkness area. That's all they know about holograms. They don't know that 20 years ago, we could project a hologram with heat, noise, light, speed, anything we wanted, anywhere. And we used that on 9/11.
Who wrote the Bible? Who wrote the Quran? And was it a lightning storm that gave birth to the earth and then dinosaurs were born? Who made up words? Who made up numbers? And what kind of spell is mankind under? Everything on the planet we preserve and can it. Microwave it and try it, no matter what, we'll survive it. What's you? What's man? What's human? Anything along the land we consuming. Eating, deleting, ruin. Trying to get paper. What? Gotta have land, gotta have acres. True. So I can sit back like Jack Nicholson, watch play the game like the Lakers.
Some of the smartest dummies can't read the language of Egyptian mummies. On a fly go a moon. And can't find food for the starving tummies. Pay no mind to the youths, cause it's not like the future depends on it. We'll save the animals in the zoo, cause the chimpanzee, them a make big money. This is how the media pillages, on TV the picture is savages and villages, and the scientists still can't explain the pyramids. Evangelists making a living on the videos of ribs of the little kids, stereotyping the image of the images, and this is what the image is. You buy a car, keep pants, and all of a sudden you will say a Indiana Jones. And I take out the gold and take out the scrolls and even the bird bones. Some of the worst paparazzi I've ever seen and I've ever known. Put the words on this place that the world can see, and that's all I will ever show. So the ones in the west will never move east and feel like it'll be at home. Get tricked by the beast, but the way them gonna flee when the monster is fully grown. Salamonic lineage where them still can't defeat and them could have never clone. My spiritual DNA that prints in my soul and I will forever own, Lord.
When you die. When you die, you have choices. You don't know this, but you have choices. When you leave your physical body, it is very typical for you to see yourself standing next to your body with either your loved ones or EMTs or whatever the circumstances are. And you see yourself, and then you'll hear a voice, you'll see the tunnel of light, and the voice will be calling you, or you will hear the voice telepathically telling you to come on, come. Now, as you stand there and you're looking at the tunnel of light, you have a choice. You can go up to this tunnel of light where you'll be with other loved ones that have crossed over, usually, all right? And you'll be put into a system where you are essentially caught in a reincarnational cycle, a loop. Or you can turn around, put the tunnel of light behind you, and what you will see is the entire universe. If you choose to go to the universe instead of the tunnel of light, whatever dimension you came from when you came down here to Earth, okay, we'll keep it all present time and place. Earth, whether it was 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th density, whatever it was, if you choose the universe and you say to yourself, I wish to go home, you will return to that dimension from which you came. So if it's 5, 6, 7, or 8, you will leave here and you will go back to that dimension, where I am told you'll be reunited with your soul. Because we're multidimensional, we're in many places at once. I've never shared this information.
Says, I heard that when we die, we should not go to the light, as it is a trick to recapture our soul to rebirth on Earth. Is that true?
Yeah, that's what I was told. Theseus was very specific. He said, you, of course, can choose to do whatever you want, but none of you ever turn around and look what's behind you. And when I asked, well, what is behind me? He said, freedom. Freedom of Earth, freedom of the reincarnational cycle.
University not long ago, and talked to a group of black law students, and I asked them to identify the names of 5 African ethnic groups that were brought to the Americas. Since there were more than 100, I just said, name me 5. And these law students could not name one. I asked them to name me 5 European ethnic groups, and they could name 20. Question has to be, how is it that students who are considered the best and the brightest go through school, K through 12, 4 years of college, and come out and have never learned the name of one African ethnic group? In other words, they don't even know who they are.
Wait a minute, who are you?
That Starbucks was losing way too much from this boycott. And they recognized that Stanley grossed from 70 mil to 750 mil because they adjusted their marketing toward women. Thus, they collabed with Stanley. Starbucks collabed with Stanley to make up for their notable losses. I will be heavily judging anyone I see with the Stanley Starbucks collab cup.
No sweet chariot, please come carry us. I don't trust the government, they tryna Jim Carrey us. Whoa now, please don't treat my life like a show now. Kick the Spurs and start a hold on. Oh, this Texas boy is getting too reckless. Sorry mama, I just wrecked the GX Lexus. I was tryna impress this chick and flex my iced out necklace and a bust out wrist, but she didn't like that. They say they want real hip hop back. They tired of that nonsense, we need to stop that. They asking me, Norm, hey, bro, when will you drop that? Man, I don't know. I'm just coming for everyone's head like a top hat. Pause. Before you walk, you crawl. They read 48 laws, but they don't know about the green on the other side. And just like Robert Kelly, I abuse my power. Curtis, when I approach these 16s, we just let the clip sing. Hallelujah, amen. I'm blocking out the shade. Haters throwing without Ray-Bans. They swearing they connected, but they really look like Rayman. Shots fired, make your praise dance. I get on the beat and stomp like Kirk Franklin. So
body when you're dreaming at night. So when you sleep for 7 or 8 hours, you're going to spend 3 hours. This is medical studies now. This is hard, no science now. We've known this since the 1950s when we discovered the four brain waves. You spend 3 hours out of the body into the fifth dimension. The question is, where do you go?
Let me explain it like this. Your soul is more physical than your physical body. People have ascension symptoms, multidimensional symptoms all the time. Headaches, dizziness, ear ringing. And the most interesting thing that everybody loves to talk about, astral projection. Your intuition, your emotions, your thoughts, your physical feelings that you get in your stomach when you're feeling something nervous or a bad feeling. That is the multidimensional things that we tap into. When you think about it, what is actually real? Because unconsciously, we do experience little pieces of the real reality. So when you travel outside of your body, you're experiencing the real reality. So when you're experiencing sleep paralysis, you're experiencing bad dreams, when you get weird feelings, when you walk into certain people's houses, you are starting to actually tap into what's really going on. When you have sleep paralysis, you're experiencing the internal reflections that attract it to you. Because those demons and those negative entities are only feeding off what you are vibrating on. But also, if you're experiencing bad sleep paralysis, you could also be attracting them because you are that powerful. And when you don't know your own power, they take advantage of that. And because you are that powerful, they will come try to see about you. So a tip for that is, don't think of yourself as a victim. Think of yourself as too powerful that they are seeing your light and they are attracted to it and they want to take some of it. So don't allow them to. That's how they were able to access you and show you exactly what's around you. So when you're dreaming at night, there is no limit to what you can do because you are not feeling the physical density.
Such as accepting the fact that this government kills its own people. It sacrifices us to advance an agenda of global control, military dominance, corporate profit. Those are the realities that so many people choose to be blinded from. Dark truths like Operation Northwoods, a government plan drafted to stage an attack and kill Americans to preempt a Cuban invasion in the 60s, JFK assassination, 9/11, or the fact that what the government tells us is safe to eat is really killing us. Or how about the fact that the corporatocracy rapes and pillages the earth simply for profit, without a care for the fate of humanity or this precious environment? And that the establishment pushes religion and political dogma onto us to stifle a collective consciousness from growing, one that may phase them out.
I used to wanna save the world till I realized saving the world don't do much for a nigga. Cursed out by the folk I don't feel out with. I'm tryna fix what's been done to my niggas. Modern Don don't do shit, but it gets you harassed and faded. Outcome be attacked and hated. Balcony assassination. Martin seen it, Malcolm seen it, Hampton seen it too. Death and dreams are camped inside my crew. Insecurity led to insurrection. CXR had broken into two. The niggas who hate versus niggas who chase progression. Look, it's easy as that. Skateful for all of my grievances. Greasy shit sent through my phone when I needed to chat. Ain't how much peace since I seen us detached.
I know the truth about it all. Greed was the root of the problem. Nobody left it as all. Cause threw me out to the dark.
When I bite back, my vic where I fight back. A bundle of dread on head like locks and nightcaps. Back the way to strive for isolation. I'm find my friends, I'm hiding my location. If I offend, apologies for sure. Extend my hand and watch as I get burned. I realize only thing that I done learned is to take time for myself. Think about you.
Trump told you so, but y'all didn't listen.
We're not African American. We're not people of color. We're not black and brown, minority, BIPOC, none of that. People, no, none of that. Strict, this is about our people demanding the resources, just as you've given these people, these newcomers who are walking into this country. And sister's correct. How do you take a new group of people that have paid no taxes, can't vote, and you put them in front of the voters?
I'm not going to pay them no damn taxes.
And so we say this to you, Mayor, Governor, President. If you think that they're that powerful, that you have to acquiesce and answer to them over us, then you tell them to vote for you in the next election. You tell them to support your Democratic National Convention. And we're going to show you how we feel about the Democratic National Convention.
Turn it up.
Thank you.
If you think you're going to have a peaceful Democratic National Convention in the city of Chicago while our people are starving, stay tuned.
Right.
Stay tuned.
All right.
Oh, we're not going to stand out like they matter. And we ask any of those who are about closing borders, we don't care if you're Republican, Democrat, or whatever, As long as you're about closing these borders, we can support you.
That's right.
And anybody who is about open borders, we're against you.
We're against you.
Plain and simple.
Those videos I posted on those earthquakes around the world on January 1st, both of them got community guidelines. And then that Miami thing happened all of a sudden. They're distracting you from the list that was supposed to be out, and they're also distracting you from the earth opening up and these creatures coming out. Some people say it was just teens at a mall shooting fireworks at each other in Miami, but some people say they were seeing creatures. Y'all gonna see something real soon. I told y'all they coming from underground. Y'all thought I was playing. But, you know, they gonna hide it. You know how media do. Media means goddess of illusions, planner, and schemer, by the way. So, you know, there's a lot of stuff that's gonna be coming from underground. All them sinkholes. You see all them sinkholes around the world? Y'all think that they disappearing for no reason? Nah, bro. This has some beans coming out that mug, bro. Big ass giant, just sinkholes all over the world, just popping up all of a sudden. And then the weather, right? Where you at? It might be foggy, right? For my people who are outside and you outside a little bit, be careful of the fog, because it might have something in there to make you sick, or you might be noticing your lungs or something messing up, or all of a sudden you got, especially when it rains. You know, all of a sudden people get sick. You know, it's supposed to be winter, but it hasn't snowed yet. Damn, they got the sky gray because they don't want that sun to come through, but the sun coming through anyway, bro. So even if you don't see the sun, you still getting sun rays out this mug, bro. They out here trying to blanket the sky, bro. It ain't gonna work. That's something to burn through them clouds, like they're gonna burn through these lizards, gray, and all them other beings that's on that baloney. Very soon, you're going to see even more changes. I already showed you Saudi Arabia. It went from desert to lush land. The blue kachina, I showed you that too. Oh, yeah. They know what time it is. Beans coming up. Aliens come from underground. Sheols. Yeah. Y'all got to understand and understand, too. There's tunnels that have been around for thousands of years. Imagine how many civilizations we had. What happens to the other civilizations? I posted a video with a Futurama where they built on top of the buildings over and over and over again. They built on top civilizations every great reset. So there's 1,000-year-old tunnels still across the world. 1,000+ years that they still use. They just don't want you to use them because you might go somewhere else, number one. Number two, you might see some critters that you ain't never seen before. You remember when China went down and that and found a whole forest underground? Y'all remember that? Y'all remember when New Zealand found a new continent underwater? Y'all remember when they found crystal pyramids in Florida? All this stuff finna activate, bro. These pyramids, these light cones, man, it's finna be beautiful. Let's go. All this other stuff they trying to do, they trying to stall. Because they know they feel like, follow, like, subscribe, baby. Share, comment. I love you.
This is one of the smugglers. They saw down pieces of our fence, right? And then he shrugs and gives a salute.
That guy you see in that video, he is connected to the cartels in one form or another. The cartels battle each other for what's called plazas, which just means space next to the border, because it's so lucrative, right? They charge every single one of those people some kind of fee to cross that border. There's an entire trafficking process, and the cartels make $13 billion a year by some estimates. So it's almost more than they make drug trafficking. So you can make a pretty good case that these cartels are a mutual enemy of both Mexico and the United States and should be dealt with in a military manner. Now, they're killing Mexicans on a daily basis. They will lure teenage boys into a call set, what they say is a call center, tell them they're going to get a job, offer them a job with the cartels, they deny them, and then they torture and kill them. That's what goes on in Mexico every single day. There is no reason why we shouldn't be using every ounce of American force, along with the Mexican military, to deal with this. And that when Secretary Blinken goes down to Mexico City in the next few days, like they supposedly are, to talk about this, that's what needs to be on the table. What are we going to do to help you take your country back? And what are you going to do to stop this mass migration? Stop facilitating mass migration into our border.
I want to discuss. That's pretty interesting. So I posted this video. They're talking about they seen aliens at Florida And then I posted the video where it was children or kids or teens shooting fireworks at each other. Somebody got beat up, a driver got beat up on this video, right? But that's not the point of this video. The point is, I just posted this today. It got 125,000 views within an hour, right? But it's something controversial, right? When it's controversy, it'll go viral. But when it's like, let me show you about your energy type of stuff. Let me show you about, you know, Tartaria, where they had Moorish Palace right there. You know what I'm saying? At a world fair. You know, that's, you know, interesting. You know, when I post stuff like this, when I post stuff like, you know, the Grand Canyon, oh, Pyramid, Grand Canyon, or, you know, stuff like this where it's a face right there in the rocks. But, you know, when I show stuff like this, though, they don't show that, which is so strange to me. Something like this, you know, some of these signs are capacitors and condensers for the top of towers and buildings, right? Something like this, you know. Where does all that free energy go, though? It make it hard for me to show this. But super interesting right here. Or that, you know, cathedrals, your Taurus field, cymatic frequencies, churches, old magic societies. Who they steal that from? Looking like Darth Lord, Dark Sith looking. I wonder where they get the idea from. Show people stuff like this. Cities that were found underneath places they were building. They won't be showing stuff like this. When I show, you know, they had a electric cars back in the 1900s, you know. I show you stuff like this, you know. These are, you know, places where ley lines are, possibly stargates around the world. When I show you, you know, alien councils, old school pyramids hidden in the mountains, you know, what you're here to do, you know. When I show you stuff like this, you know, created humans, just saying. I show you stuff like this, you know, these are how cities used to look at Atlantis. These are how some of the cities would look. And you're like, what? Let me see. Cities used to float. These are cymatic cities, aka star cities. You know, when I show you, you know, stuff like this, it'd be hard for them to show you stuff. That's so crazy to me. Sort of like some world tree was there at one point or something. It's almost like it was a world tree planted across the world in different places that had made the sky look like this. But anyway, it's crazy how controversy is pushed because they want you to argue. Follow, like, subscribe, share.
I'm over at Epstein Island. Everybody knows that. And guess what? She ain't saying shit. And if I was her, I wouldn't either. She got a golden ticket with the information that she got. And if I was her, I'd hold on to it as long as I can. They can't pay that woman enough money. The things that Naomi Campbell knows, ain't nobody ready for that. That's Delilah. The woman that can do what no other man could do. Naomi Campbell's a very powerful chick. And I don't give a shit what no Janice Dickinson say. Naomi Campbell is for real the first supermodel. And by the way, Naomi Campbell is the only woman on the face of this planet that Mike Tyson was ever afraid of. Mike Tyson actually had a restraining order on Naomi Campbell. That's how bad Naomi Campbell is, that she scared Mike Tyson.
If it's anything I took from this interview, it was this. This was gold right here.
I done already told you, I'm one of the richest people that ever lived.
Yes.
Only in the fact that when I wake up in the morning, no matter where I am, I don't need nothing.
That's good.
Whatever I need is right around me. And whatever I don't have, it's only just because I don't have it. It's not because I can't get it. All I got to do is want it, and it belongs to me. So
hello.
Because of that, because I'm favored by God, like when I see people's wives and stuff, I don't even look at them. You know what I mean? Like, I don't want to look at nothing I don't want to have.
What?
Because I know how blessed I am. If I look at it, I got it.
That man knows something. I don't even look at things I don't want, because if I look at it, I'll have it. That's how favored I am by God. Be careful what you're looking at.
y'all, y'all gonna act like y'all in here Seeley curses man? Y'all gonna act like y'all in here Seeley curses man? Okay, let me roll the clip.
Until you do right by me, everything you think about is gonna
be gone. You're black, you're poor, you're ugly, you a woman. I should have kept under my shoe with the vote you is.
Everything done to me, already done to you. I may be black, I may be poor, I may even be ugly, but I'm here.
This is one of the most iconic curses in a movie, I swear, to me at least, okay? Because it's like, she not just cursing him for nothing. She like, until you do right by me, everything you think about is going to crumble. Like, what's more iconic than that? Because if you do me wrong, your life going to be fucked up. But if you do me right, you'll be all right. Like, what's more iconic than that? Because people be out here cursing people for no reason. But it's like, until you do right by me. Because if you don't do me wrong, then you good, bro. You good. But anybody that's thinking about doing wrong to me, all your life is going to be fucked up in my eyes. Okay? One of the most iconic curses, okay? When my friend told me about this back in the day, the color purple, this is one of the things that stuck with me, this curse, okay? It stuck with me since I was a teenager, y'all. Because it's like, that's real valid. That curse real valid. It's real valid. Like, who don't want people to do right by them? And then if you do wrong by me, nigga, I want you to get your justice. I want you to get your justice. So, baby, this is the most iconic curse to me in a movie. And it teaches you, one, to take back your power, to stand up for yourself, because that's what she did here, okay? She took back her power and she stood up for herself, okay? And she spoke up for herself. She's teaching you how the power in the tongue is so fucking powerful here, because what did he do after this, okay? He got his shit together and he even brought her sister home.
Hey, sister.
Look, he brought her ass back, right? That curse worked, huh?
Going down by the river's gonna play with you.
Now, y'all, I had to replay this back because she sound like an old school conjurer, root worker, okay? A hoodoo lady, the woo-woo lady. Listen.
Done to me. Already done to
me. Don't she sound like she casting spells? This is my move for the rest of my life, okay? Until you do right by me, everything you think about is gonna crumble. Play with your mama, don't play with me.
They said that I sell my soul. Should I just tell them the truth?
He sold it for a double cheeseburger with
mac sauce. With extra onions on it, baby. Don't play. It's time for me to just keep it a honey with y'all. Like, yes, they got me in this shit. I don't know. I can't get out of it. I'm getting too much money. I don't want to get out of it. I did. I'm in this shit, man. I'm in this shit.
Y'all,
that's what y'all wanted to hear. Now I'm saying it. They talk about stop playing. Yes, I'm with the Illuminati.